corner of Cherry Street. We would walk on the beach in our bare feet. We were both 18 and it felt so right. Sleeping all day, staying up all night.
Welcome to the video. I've been so sick the first 3 days that we were here. And then yesterday I started feeling a little bit better. So yesterday was like the first real day that we kind of like went around and explored and everything. So today I think we're gonna go to a couple of villas. Alright, we are in Bellagio. I got the cappuccino. And we're walking up and going to the villa.
Yes.
Okay, we're going to the villa and then, what, lunch or something? Dinner?
Yeah.
Step one to losing weight on vacation, get really sick. Just kidding. No, but I was really sick for the first couple days of the trip, and then I slept so much, like for like 16 hours, and I'm not kidding. Had some really strong Italiano medicine. And then I felt better. So step one, walk a lot.
This is the most amount of activity that I've done all week. And so you're supposed to sip the cappuccinos. It took me like 2 minutes and it's gone. This is a problem. I'm so used to having like giant cups of coffee at home that when I get these small things, I'm just like, I drink it so quickly. I thought I was gonna have like a caffeine detox when I was here, but third one.
I mean, a lot.
It's all good though. Did the trick. Cute that there's like little gardens by the water, little places to sit, so I think we're gonna go hang out. I wish I would have brought my bathing suit, but it's okay. Tomorrow. We should have brought our bathing suit.
I know.
I did.
Well, we can swim. We're in Bellagio right now. We're at this cute little lunch spot. So they have like restaurants behind me. I don't know if you can see. Like this little park that everyone kind of like has a picnic at, it seems like. And there's like a little swimming pool next door. Dead.
Step two, choose pretty healthy meals. When I say pretty healthy, find something on the menu that has a decent amount of protein, some vegetables in there, some healthy fats, some carbs if you want them. I mean, everything had bread at the beginning of it. Choose pretty healthy meals, you'll be okay. Next up, do a couple little circuits, even if it's only 10 or 15 minute little workouts. I was there for 2 weeks, I probably only did 2 or 3 actual like little workouts. I did 2 circuits and then I did a little run and that was it for 2 weeks. But this stimulated my muscles and allowed me to still get a sweat and allowed me to burn some calories. I felt good and I was still walking a lot, so I was very active. But do some circuits. Whenever you can, get something done.
All right, so I first timed myself. I did about 1 minute of box jumps. So I found a ledge that was high enough for me to jump on with a beautiful view. I did some box jumps here, stepped down. So I did 1 minute of this, 5 rounds. And then I moved on to, you'll see in 5 seconds, push-ups. Spider-Man push-ups with my knee in, so I use the same ledge. You can do just straight decline push-ups if you want to without bringing your knee in, but this makes it a lot harder. Really works your core and obliques, so I did this again. I did this for actually 30 seconds each. Then I moved on to dips. I did this for 1 minute. I did 5 rounds of each thing. So 1 minute, 30 seconds, 1 minute. And then the last thing that I did was Bulgarian or split squat jump lunges. Okay, so this was actually really tough. It really burned my legs out. You do 5 rounds of this, you'll start to feel it, trust me. So that was basically the circuit, and then I finished with a little bit of a stair sprint.
All right, we're finishing.
I just did this 2 times, down and up, just to kind of like, you know, get a little bit of a sweat going, a little bit more. So I ran down, sprinted up. It wasn't much, but I promise you it was a great finisher. If you have a longer staircase, even better. So that was my circuit.
And then choose some not so healthy meals. This will allow you to have things in moderation where you're not going to feel deprived. You're not going to feel like you want to go binge later and eat the stuff that you didn't let yourself have in the moment. It's so much better to allow yourself to enjoy certain foods, especially when you're traveling. And then you're not going to feel like you need it or you really want it later on. You're going to get it out of your system. You'll have a little bit and then you're good.
I may or may not have gotten a cheese pizza immediately after.
I think I lost my family, but I stopped and I got a little watermelon cantaloupe fruit cup, and then I got a little coffee, and I need to go find my parents because we're going to the gardens right now. I actually just woke up not that long ago, but I'm planning on eating a little bit later. I've been waiting a little bit and having a bigger lunch, bigger dinner, and then just like a little snack for breakfast. It's been working very well. So we just made it to the Balboli Gardens. I have my little fruit cup and my coffee. So we're walking in, and this is where like the Medici family used to live. So it's a freaking like ginormous palace, basically. It's pretty cool so far. I'll show you guys around. Okay, so I guess the flowers are not out right now, but we're walking. This place is ginormous. Didn't wear the right shoes for it.
I should have done better with that.
Try to avoid snacking. Snacking is the worst thing that you can do when you're traveling. It's just not good. Those little calories from a snack most likely will not fill you up, and it's just gonna add a bunch of extra calories. So when I did snack, I chose fruit. I chose like little items that I could share with other people, and this really helped me to not load up on the calories. So I had bigger meals, and this really helped me because those bigger meals kept me full. I looked forward to it. That way I only had like, you know, maybe two big meals a day. And then I might have had a snack that I shared with someone else. And this allowed me to keep my calories in check. And I didn't eat mindlessly without really knowing how many calories I was intaking. I kind of had a good idea. And that way I could really space my meals out, allow my body to digest those meals. And I wasn't putting unnecessary things in my body when I didn't need it.
I gave you all the basil. Ooh, pear. I was gonna say, where's our water? It sits right there all along.
Couldn't read anything on the menu, so I got chicken.
You got steak, beef,
and pasta.
Still hungry after dinner.
Today we're in beautiful Florence, Italy. I'm gonna take you through a hill run to the top of the hill where you can see the entire city of Florence at Michelangelo Square. So this is a really long hill, so you wanna make sure that you're focusing on form, really lifting your knees and driving with your arms and staying relaxed to get through the whole entire hill. Let's go. When you're on vacation, there's so many things that you can do aside from eating and drinking to get your mind off of food. There's places you can see, there's activities that you can do that is not surrounded by food and drinks. It does not always have to be that way. So do whatever you can that does not involve eating out.
All right, we're almost there. Make sure your arm swing and knee lift is consistent. All right, we just finished with the hill. Let's go down here where it's quieter. Okay, so this hill is almost a mile long, so you really want to make sure on this one that you're focusing on breathing. So what really helps me is breathing in through my nose, count of 1, 2, 3, out a count of 2, to make sure that you're not breathing too quickly. You also want to make sure that you stay focused on your form. The second you lose form, you're going to get slower and you are finished. You're not going to be as good going up that hill, and you're not going to be able to finish it as toughly as you would if you focus more on form. So get that knee drive and the arm swing going, and you're good to go. All right, by this point, you probably have a little bit of lactic acid buildup, so we're gonna do a light recovery jog. It's about a quarter mile to the vista where you can see the whole city of Florence. We're on our recovery run. Here we are in beautiful Florence. Now, don't forget these tips. It'll make your hill workouts a lot easier. Now, if you can't be in Florence, go ahead and do it in your own hometown. All right, this one is a great one to focus on that knee lift, especially when you're driving up hills. So on this one, you want to lunge, arm back. You're really driving that knee up, exploding. Explode up. puff.
Okay, so we'll get one cream puff, and then you said that cinnamon the best one, or what's the best one that you have here? The chocolate.
Yeah, no, I'm the chocolate.
Chocolate. Has Nutella inside, right?
And then I'm going to be
next time, what's gonna happen?
No, but for now, I need to do that. I went shopping with my mom, I was flipping.
We'll make
really chocolate.
It's
okay. It's just,
okay. When you're at a place like Italy, a lot of the stuff is minimal ingredients or is actually pretty clean ingredients, which is great. So places like that allows you to eat healthy, it allows you to feel good. Even the not so healthy stuff, for some reason, you don't feel as bad as you would when you eat stuff in America. It's just the ingredients that they use, which is awesome. I love it. So when you're out, point of the story is stay active, order as healthy as you can, share things with others, get some circuits in if you can, and don't worry so much about it. I feel like the more you worry about dieting, the more you screw up. Like, the less you worry, I feel like the better it is, the more you stay on track. It's funny how it works that way, but just less stress is better, man. So that's what I got for you. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and let me know what else you guys want to see, even though no one really watches my videos, but it's okay. I'll still keep recording them. Okay, bye. Oh my gosh, was my camera crooked the whole time? I think it was. I'm so bad with that. I'm sorry. Okay, bye.